Hi, hello everyone. Back to yet another School Synergy session. This is the ideation and implementation reflection session for the last week's session that we did with Uma Kogekar. Uma is there with us, and I'm really thankful, Uma, that you were able to join again for this session. The session was on using videos to build reflective teachers. Now, we really need to have some sort of submissions by you to take this forward. And one or two people have submitted their own videos. But if it would be really nice for you to also go through the teacher pages video, even though some of them are in Marathi, but there is an English subtitles there. And you can learn a lot from watching others practice. In fact, you know, there was a research I was reading just a day before, and what was done was to ask teachers what they find useful and important in their teacher professional development. So a lot of teachers said, yes, that we read books. And yes, I agree, that's a very useful. Then they said that we share with colleagues. But we need to know in what form they share with colleagues. Of course, they must be doing a lot of conversations in the staff room. And I do not know in this online mode, to what extent do you get that kind of staff room space? Then they said that we do courses and it increases our qualification and it helps. So yes, that is also a good way. But what they considered least important was, and which was a bit surprising to me, was watching other peers' classroom teaching. They didn't consider that as important enough to improve their professional capacities. But I think that is a very, very important way to understand teaching, to look at others' teachers' practice, to reflect using that practice on one's own practice. So I again invite you all to have a look at different videos which are posted across so many social media platforms, including teacher pages, including your own video, and think how this video can help us to reflect on the teaching itself. One essential thing that we really need to remember is not to criticize the teacher, because the teacher can be anybody in any kind of situation and may have to perform in a certain way because the conditions are like that. But we need to focus on the teaching aspect. Like what are the practices that are helping students to articulate their thoughts? Like in a previous session, when we did with Uma, it was really nice to see the teacher had used that blackboard for students to elicit students to speak about their ideas, students to write about their ideas in their own languages. So these kind of things really help. Now, I don't want to just go on speaking. I also want other members to share and speak about this topic itself. So anyone can start, and if they have watched any video, they can speak about that. They can share the video. I will give them sharing rights. And if they want to show their own video, they are welcome to do that also. Okay, who wants to go now? Ishani, is that you speaking?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Okay, go ahead. Yeah.
Ma'am, I watched a video in teacher's page.
Okay.
And it was an English teaching.
Okay.
Language class.
Okay. Yes, you can discuss. Do you want to share the video here, or do you want to post a link of that video that you had seen in the chat? What do you want to do?
Ma'am, I have not kept it as link. I can...
Could you tell us the name? Maybe I'll be able to tell you which video it is if you tell me the name.
Name of the concept also, if you are able to tell.
I am just telling you the concept. I'll send the link as I search, and I'll send it in the chat box. Want to share first that, or shall I first post and then share? Tell me accordingly.
First you post, because everyone needs to know. Thank you. They need to get a context.
Search and post, and then I'll share. Okay, thank you.
Okay. While Ishani is looking for that and posting, it will take some time for her. May I have volunteer? Anybody else want to volunteer for sharing their reflections or their own video? Who's speaking? Is anyone speaking? Okay. I'm sorry, I'm not able to identify who's speaking. Can you please speak again?
So right now, no one has done a raise hand.
Yeah, you can raise hand. You can raise hand, definitely. Jasneet, would you like to share?
Actually, I was waiting somebody else to go first and then I'll go.
Okay. I think Ishani is sharing. Jasneet has a mathematics video of her own to share. And okay. We will be very much interested in looking at that. If anyone else had seen any video and they want to talk about it, it would be really nice. See, this, you need to understand that this is not the session in which we will again start sharing. We want you to start sharing. So please, you need to take a step. You need to take a step forward and come up with some ideas.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Rachna.
Yes, Rachna. Please go ahead.
No. Since I just joined now because of some internet issue, so if I have understood correctly, we are going to have a discussion based on the ideation and implementation reflection using videos. So for that, are we looking at only our videos that we have?
Not necessarily. That's what I said. You can use your own video. You can use teacher pages video that we had used last time. There are hundreds of videos available on teacher pages site. You can use any other videos available on social media, WhatsApp groups, or any other thing which you have the possibly the right to share. If you are sharing any other teacher's video with whom you have not taken the permission, that would be difficult. You need to take the permission first from the teacher. But your own video, you don't need to take any permission. You can definitely share teacher pages video because this is already there in the public space and they have already made it public for other people to see. So that would not be an issue. You can share any other video on YouTube also, because that also people have already made it public. And we are not sharing to criticize. We are sharing to reflect. That is what our purpose is, right?
So if I use videos from YouTube for my subject, chemistry,
okay.
Do you mean that we can share those videos also?
You can share and tell us. See, the purpose for sharing is what? We want you to reflect on teaching practices. Like when you're sharing that, what exactly is you want to highlight or underline in terms of teaching of science? What are the practices that are helping? Is it a video of a teacher teaching science, or is it a video which is just involves some sort of explanation? If it is of only explanation, what exactly is it that is that you feel really helps the two students in understanding that concept? If not, so then what more do you want? That kind of thing.
So may I just share one video? I just used it the other day. Science related, chemistry related, simple video of one of the reactions. Can I do that?
Sure, go ahead. Right now, because there are hardly any people sharing. We would love to see that. Yeah.
If you give me the...
Yeah, I'll make you the co-host right now. Do you have the link ready with you?
In a second, I'm just opening it because it's all there.
So just wait. I think Ishani must have got ready. So let's go to Ishani first. And after that, Rachna, you can come in. Okay, yeah. I'll make you the co-host. Sure. Ishani, are you ready?
Ma'am, please give me some time.
because as I have opened it in my desktop, I am unable.
It is taking time.
All these things happen.
You have to switch off your video and that it will be easier. Rachna, I have made you the co-host. You can share.
I'm just starting it.
You are on mute, Ruchi.
I'm sorry. I was just saying, if anybody else is interested, at least please raise your hand so that I know that whom to go after Rachna and Ishani and Jasneet. Anybody else interested in sharing their reflections or ideas?
May I share?
Yes, please go ahead. We are waiting.
So this is the video which I had used, actually number of videos I had used for my lesson that day. For example, I'll just share the lesson. I had taken what is a decomposition reaction, and I had discussed with them, you know, various decomposition reactions, and I tried to show them where a teacher is demonstrating rather than animation ones. Okay. So that they know that you know, these experiments can be carried out in the laboratory, and they could see it exactly how the teacher is going about these experiments.
Ishani, this video, does it have you teaching, or it doesn't have? It's not a recording of your own teaching.
No, ma'am. This is Rachna here, and that is what I said. I have used a video from YouTube, you know, for my class. Okay. So, I have not been able to make my own videos because we don't have this kind of facilities.
Okay.
So do you want me to continue? Otherwise, I will switch it off. It's okay, ma'am.
No. You can show. I was very interested to see whether we are going to see, you know, like Ruchi was saying, we are reflecting on our own practice, right? Anyhow, even this will do because you've been able to at least find the video that you've used, right? So let's begin with that. It's a good idea.
So do you want to...
Please go ahead.
Run this video? Should I run it?
Yes, please.
Yes, please do.
Okay.
Our next chemical reaction is going to be looking at the decomposition of calcium carbonate. So in this test tube right here, I have the white powder calcium carbonate. So what first thing we're going to do is decompose it by putting it over heat. I'm going to do that by holding it over my Bunsen burner. Now I'm going to hold it over my Bunsen burner for about 2 minutes. So I'll come back when I'm done. Now I've been holding this over the Bunsen burner for approximately 2 minutes. At this point, the calcium carbonate should have decomposed to calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. The problem is that calcium oxide looks very similar to calcium carbonate. They are both white powders. However, I can see if CO2 is present. So I'm going to take my wooden splint right here, and I'm going to set it on fire and put it in this tube. If CO2 is present, that means that it is going, the flame on my wooden splint is going to be put out, thus indicating the presence of CO2. If my wooden splint flame does not go out, it stays burning, and I'll know that CO2 is not present and that this chemical reaction was unsuccessful. So let's take a look. Got my wooden splint burning, we put it in, and the flame goes out, indicating that we had CO2 present, meaning this white powder became calcium oxide.
So, ma'am, that was the experiment. And Of course, there were another four or more of different reactions. This is one of them.
I think this is good that you shared this one. And we would like to know your thoughts about this. Like, why did you use it?
Ma'am, please continue.
I was just asking that what was your thinking behind that? Why did you use it? What is it that you find very useful? Is it that because the person was showing you the chemical reaction?
Ma'am, see, first was, as I told earlier, that I wanted this time experiments to be performed in the laboratory. You know, I want to show the children those kind of experiments rather than animated ones. You know, we have all kinds of experiments available. One is that. Secondly, as I was searching this, in this experiment, what happens is the teacher has shown another test for carbon dioxide. Normally, when carbon dioxide evolves, we show it, we show the test by passing it through freshly prepared lime water, you know?
Yeah.
So this time the teacher showed that the burning splint gets extinguished. So that was another aspect which, and third is that it was quite a short video. So for me, in my 40 minute class, I could show a number of experiments and it was very clear what the teacher was doing. So this was my objective.
Okay, I just want everyone to also share their thoughts about this video. What did you feel about it? Is this a good video? Is this a good resource to show in the classroom?
I wanted to just, I was just thinking like we, now, I would like to ask Rachna also, like nowadays we have so many simulations where students try to put the chemicals in the test tube and these kinds of simulation, like FET simulation, we have put the chemical and something will come out. So it's like a virtual laboratory. So why did you prefer this video? I mean, a short video is, I can understand this one is a good objective, but why did you, for the other objectives, why did you prefer this kind of video instead of the virtual labs? That I just would like to know.
You know, I, Jasni, thank you for, you know, interacting with me, and maybe my thought processes will also get cleared and I will be able to implement something better next time. I know about simulated reactions. I know about virtual labs. There are n number of them. But when I was taking this lesson, apart from showing just videos, what I was doing side by side was, when we were discussing like what is a decomposition reaction, I gave them first the just the name of a reaction. That is, what do you think would happen when a certain substance is heated? Like, for example, here it was calcium carbonate. So I asked them, what do you think would happen if calcium carbonate is heated? Think about it, write a skeletal equation, okay? So after they wrote, they discussed, they shared, some came out with products which were not at all matching what was expected. Some could, were very close, and some were bang on. And then I didn't give them that, yes, the, I said, come on, let's verify now what are the products being formed. And that is how my, this lesson was. Maybe in my next class, when I'm taking a revision for them, once I finish, I will help ask them to go for simulations and try working out with different solutions and see for them, themselves, what happens.
So I wanted to ask you a question that when you're using this kind of a resource, you know, to sort of demonstrate, you know, a particular reaction, I mean, I don't know science well enough to comment on it, but from what I understood was that this was a sort of a confirmation inquiry that was happening, isn't it? I mean, you asked children to make certain predictions.
Yes, ma'am.
Then the children were doing a sort of confirmation inquiry, is that right?
Yes, like they were trying to think that if it decomposes, what could be formed? like some out of the blue would said that carbon and oxygen means very, very not related at all. So, and some...
That's fine. So, Rachna, my question, I mean, I'm just thinking aloud, okay?
Yes.
My question is that when you began this lesson, right? Yeah. And you might use a FET simulation, or you might use such a video like this, or one might use a combination of these. And it's always good to have variety in class. And I think a lot of teachers do try to do that.
Yes, ma'am.
When you began this lesson,
yes,
did the students know what the investigative question was?
Yes. In the sense that when before I showed them the video, as I said, ma'am, I told them to think about the reaction. How would it proceed?
Rachna, when you talk about asking them to think about the reaction and what is going to happen, right? That is actually a prediction.
Yes,
right?
Correct.
So in the inquiry-based cycle of learning and teaching, prior to the step of prediction, sometimes you sort of elaborate what is the investigation, what is it that we're investigative in the first place, right? Then, of course, you come to prediction so on and so forth, of course. So, in your mind, what was the investigative question? And was it clear to the students right at the very start, or did you feel it needed to be put in later? There are different ways of doing it. But typically, in an inquiry-based cycle, you begin with a problem statement. You ask children to arrive at a driving question and an investigative question after that. And then you think about, what are the variables you're going to vary, and then predict, and then move the cycle on. So is that how you thought about it, or was it a little different?
If I have to say what I went on, so maybe I began with the, first of all, what are the types of reactions? So under that type, one was the decomposition. So how can a decomposition reaction be brought about? What are the ways by which we can bring about a decomposition reaction? That was my first question to the students, ma'am. Okay.
It was a how. How can you do something?
Yes. Okay. So first was like what it is. What is it? What do you mean by decomposition? Okay. Then how can you bring about a decomposition reaction? In what ways can a substance decompose? Okay. So that we had discussed from our environment related. That do you observe these kind of reactions in your day-to-day life? And what brings about these reactions? Okay. And from that, then I picked up, as I told you, I shared. Maybe somewhere I may not have gone as per your thought process, ma'am. I may have been a little...
Everybody's thought process may be different.
This is how basically I went about. And then there were other questions related to the video itself. So it's not that they see the video completely and then, so in between we pause the video, we ask them to observe and then think why it is so and all. So that's how it goes for me.
Okay.
Yeah. So I think Zainab Mala has her hand raised, and I also wanted to ask one question after her. Okay. And I hope, Rachna, it is okay for us to discuss this further.
Yes, ma'am, definitely. Yeah, because we can learn from this, I feel.
Yes, definitely. Zainab, over to you.
Yes, ma'am. Talking about the choice of stimulation and a video of an experiment, I would say that for the topic which Rachna ma'am had taken, even I would go for an experiment video. I normally use stimulations for things which cannot be seen easily. For example, if I want to show that when NaOH is added to water, the dissociation of ions taking place. Okay, those NaCl is added to water, the dissociation. For all those things, I would use a stimulation, because even in a lab, I cannot show them the ions or the atoms. But for things where where you can observe physically, where you can heat a salt and observe that this is what is happening. If I put a burning splinter, it is going to blow off. So for those things, even I would go for an experiment where they have a, we can't say live experience, but at least they see that experience right now in the virtual lab. So depending on that, we decide whether to take a stimulation or an experimental video.
Yeah. Thanks for sharing that, Zainab. It's really nice to know what kind of practices people are using, especially, I mean, this is nice discussion on chemistry. We can also discuss other subjects. But yes, I just wanted to put one point. Like when we are selecting any resource, how do we select it? On what is the basis? One, you are saying is that it provides some sort of simulation of something which cannot be actually seen. It's something abstract. But here we were just heating the salt, and it, the description that the salt is not changing any color or anything, it's given by the speaker. And it is, the camera is also not very close to the salt to see whether the color is changing or not changing right now. And even the putting the splinter inside, the burning splinter inside. I just want you all to think, would students be convinced that the splinter got extinguished because there was a CO2 present? And it is something that we had already told them that, you know, we need to check whether CO2 is released or not, and we'll put the splinter inside. And if it extinguishes, it means that CO2 is present. Could there be other explanations for it? Can students come up with any other explanations for why splinter got extinguished when we put it inside?
Yeah, any they ideas? Could have thought that if the fan is on or something.
Yeah, they could have thought that. Others could have also thought that when you put something in a sand or powder, burning splinter, then also it extinguished because you know, you're just putting some pressure on it. So just putting some pressure on it, that extinguishes the splinter. That can, they can also think. So how do we address? No, I'm not saying that there is anything wrong with the video itself. But what I'm saying is, as a teacher, when we are selecting any resource, one important thing that we do need to consider is the kinds of misconceptions that students may have. And Uma would also, share in what way teachers really think about the way students think, the kind of misconceptions they have, and how to address them when they are making videos with the teachers itself. So even when you're using a video, you need to think about that. So you pointed out a very major misconception that when something like calcium carbonate is being heated, students say carbon and oxygen, and they do not know from where that is coming. So this is some sort of a random answer they are giving. But can you also think of why this answer is coming out? What they are thinking to say this kind of answer? Just want you to think a little bit on these points.
One of the things I think, Ruchi, one of the programs now that we are talking about, particularly a science lesson, as part of the work that we are doing, we are also doing teaching of STEM, how do you teach science using inquiry-based methods of learning and teaching. And we are currently doing this project with some schools in Navi Mumbai, Mumbai and Thane. And this project is also running in Goa and Kolkata, and I think Aurangabad. So we've had a lot of discussion with teachers, and we've sort of tried to get them towards adopting an inquiry-based cycle of learning and teaching, which is why I was a little bit curious to understand that when Rachna was talking about, I showed this video, then I asked this question, then I asked them to predict, and then they confirmed, right? So I would have sort of liked to understand and step back a little bit for earlier, what is it that is being investigated? So the investigation question versus the how question and observation question is different. These are all connected and, they are linked to each other. So what is it that you're investigating? The effect of something on something, or, what is the driving question that we are actually trying to establish over here? I would say, Ruchi, that the choice of the resource material that is used is a small part of the entire cycle of the learning and teaching, okay? So I don't know whether there is time or I don't know, we might end up shifting the focus of this session today, but I can show you three or four slides which we have used in the past to elicit a little bit of a discussion on inquiry-based listening. And then with respect to that, if Rachna or anyone else would like to reflect, maybe one could think about how did that lesson go? So if you think that is the way to go, Ruchi, we can do that, or we can park that aside for some time and actually go back to any videos anyone wants to share.
So I just wanted to ask if Ishani and Jasneet would be interested in showing some video. If they have some, then let's see that. And at the end, perhaps if you share that slides, it may help all the teachers in that sense, right? So is Ishani ready? Were you able to find Uma, the video that she was referring to?
I posted it on the chat box.
Actually, I am still searching for that video.
I have shared the video, Ishani. It's there in the chat box.
It's there in the chat box, and we can show it for you if you want.
Okay, yes ma'am, surely. I saw that in chat box that there is a link.
Okay, yeah. So Uma, do you want to share it or should I?
I'm at this same video. Yes, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
There is a story behind every video. So when you tell me the name of the concept, I know. We know very closely and we know there is a story behind it with you actually.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. So I liked the way she used origami for the students to construct the background for that how they are doing the things.
Maybe, Ruchi, would you be able to share?
Yes, I'm trying.
Quite sure why the line.
आपको ओरिगेमी पता है? किस किस को पता है? हाथ ऊपर करिए. सबको पता है. अच्छी बात है. क्या क्या बनाते हो आप ओरिगेमी से? हाँ, समृद्धि.
हम कागज से घर, नाव, बदक इत्यादि चीजें बनाते हैं.
विद्यार्थी ओरिगेमी बनाते हुए सही क्रम में उसके निर्देश लिखना सीखते हैं। यह करते समय बच्चे सही शब्द का उपयोग करते हुए अपने आप वाक्य बनाते हैं। हिंदी यह बच्चों की मातृभाषा न होकर तीसरी भाषा है, इसलिए यह अनुभव उन्हें वाक्य बनाने में मदद करते हैं। पहला चरण, चरण मतलब कृति, तो उसका पहला चरण क्या होगा? हम चीज बना रहे और उसके लिए हमें पहली कृति लिखनी है।
पहले हम एक वर्गाकार कागज लिया,
तो हमने वर्गाकार कागज लिया तो साथ में हम इसकी आकृति भी निकालेंगे। अभी हम नाव बना रहे, नाव बनाने के लिए दूसरी कृति क्या करेंगे?
हम दो कोनों को आपस में जोड़ेंगे,
ऊपर नीचा या मतलब कैसे आप दिखा सकते हो कैसे?
ये ऐसा कागज है,
तो हम जो वर्गाकार के जो है कोने हैं, तो इन दोनों को हम आमने सामने के कोनों को जोड़ेंगे, तो क्रम वो वाक्य कैसे लिखेंगे? हम
आमने सामने दोनों भुजाएं को जोड़ेंगे,
भुजाएं को जोड़ेंगे, नहीं तो हम ये कोना भी कह सकते हैं, कोने को जोड़ेंगे। तो हम दूसरा चरण लिखेंगे, अभी इसका आकार कैसा है?
इसका आकार आयत है।
आयत, तो सबका आकार ऐसा हुआ है, आयताकार। तो इसे मराठी में आयत बोलते हैं, लेकिन हिंदी में हम आयताकार ऐसे बोलते हैं। तो यहाँ पे नया शब्द लिखेंगे, आयताकार। तो ये आयताकार का हम अभी तीसरा चरण करने के लिए उपयोग करेंगे। क्रम के हिसाब से पूरा वाक्य साथ में बनाते हैं। हिंदी बच्चों की तीसरी भाषा होने के कारण बच्चे मराठी भाषा में सोचते हुए मराठी शब्द का उपयोग करते हैं। यहाँ पर विद्यार्थी व्याकरण और सही शब्द का उपयोग एक सही वाक्य बनाने के लिए कैसे किया जाता है यह सीखते हैं। हमने अभी सातवां चरण लिखने के लिए हम यहाँ पे क्या शब्द इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं? हाँ सोहम बताओ।
हम आखिर में ऊपर के कोनों को बाहर खींचा,
तो हमें आखिर में ये शब्द हमें इस्तेमाल करना है। तो सातवां चरण यहाँ पे आखिर में ऊपर के कोनों को बाहर की तरफ खींचो और आपके पैरी सी नाव तैयार हो गई। हाँ, तो हमने ये जो शब्द इस्तेमाल किए हैं, पहले, उसके बाद, अब, फिर से, अब, फिर और आखिर में, ये हमने क्यों इस्तेमाल किया है?
उसके बाद हमें जो कुछ भी करना है वो समझ में आए, इसलिए हमने ये सब शब्द।
हाँ, वेरी गुड। तो हम जो भी कृति कर रहे हैं तो उसका कुछ सही क्रम होता है, तो वो क्रम हम जब लिखते हैं तो ये शब्द का हम इस्तेमाल करते हैं। अब हम एक दूसरी एक्टिविटी करने जा रहे हैं।
विद्यार्थियों को जोड़ियों में बिठा कर एक वस्तु तैयार करनी है। वस्तु बनाते हुए उसके निर्देश सही क्रम में लिखने हैं। क्रम लिखते हुए बच्चे नए शब्द का उपयोग सही क्रम में करते हैं और पूरा वाक्य बनाते हैं।
ये आपकी कौन सी रेखा है? हमारे पाठशाला के बच्चों को हस्तकला यह विषय अलग अलग तरीके से सिखाया जाता है। बच्चों को जब कोई कृति दी जाती है तब वह उसमें बहुत मग्न हो जाते हैं। विद्यार्थी जब अपने हाथों से काम करते हैं तब उनके हाथ, दिमाग और मन का विकास होता है। इससे उनका आत्मविश्वास और भी बढ़ता है। ओरिगामी अपने आप में ही क्रम से बनने वाली एक कृति है, इसीलिए हस्तकला का संबंध भाषा से जोड़ते हुए वस्तु की कृति लिखने के लिए मैंने उसे चुना।
पहले वर्गाकार कागज लो, उसके बाद वर्गाकार के दोनों कोनों को जोड़ो।
Thanks for showing that video, ma'am.
You're welcome. This is one of the more recent videos.
Thank you so much, Ishani. This is really nice. And we would love to hear your thoughts also about it, what it made you reflect about.
As ma'am has already, you only have told that it is a way to link maths also along with this language. So it is like linking vertically with other subjects, as well as students are now able to construct sentences in a systematic order. The teacher is also helping along them to construct the sentences. And so I like this video as it is a fun way to learn the language. Otherwise, as such, if we go on telling them to write some paragraph or something, it becomes at times it becomes boring for the students. So as they are doing it along with the activity, so it is very they are not in a way not very for them it is not a boredom. They are in a fun way learning the things. That I feel.
Okay, so what do you think is the purpose of the lesson, Ishani? Or somebody else can also speak, not just Ishani. Ishani has done some nice sharing. What is the purpose of this lesson? ये lesson के आखिर में बच्चों को क्या आना चाहिए? आपको क्या लगता है, Ishani?
Language formation of sentences in a proper manner.
So is it formation of any particular type of sentence or any sentence? Is there any focus within language?
They are connecting the sentences together to frame the whole of this thing.
Language सीखने में क्या specific चीज सीख रहे हैं? उन्होंने कौन से words underline किए थे? वो क्या बच्चों को help कर?
फिर आखिर में हाँ ये सब words उन्होंने और उनके लिए ये था कि third language के रूप में हिंदी सीख रहे हैं तो they are not very able to are not knowing many of the words of Hindi. So she is imposing stress on those words. Ki kis tarike se? Mane they are thinking in Marathi and converting as a normally we do for English also. The same way we think in our mother tongue or in our Hindi and then we frame the sentence in English. Similarly, for them also, it is a third language. And she is means stressing certain of the things so that students can means think it at once in Hindi also.
Okay, very nice, Ishani. Here, Anupama Ruchi has said that the use of
sequential words, yes.
So, this is, so thank you, Anupama, for pointing this out. So you're becoming more specific in your observation, right? So look at how three types of observations we've got. I mean, I think we've got others also. Ishani ne kaha ki bachcho ko language aana chahiye. Phir Sudha has said children will learn new words. Now Anupama is saying children will learn sequential words, right? So as you start observing more closely and you start stating it, you're becoming more specific in your observation. So the language learning outcome, agar hum soche to language learning to bahut vast topic hai na. उसको हम छोटे 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 हिस्सों में बांट के बच्चों को सिखाते हैं. एक ही टाइम में तो लैंग्वेज आता नहीं है, चाहे वो फर्स्ट लैंग्वेज हो, सेकंड लैंग्वेज हो, एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो तो एनीवे इट इज नॉट द फर्स्ट लैंग्वेज. सो द टीचर हैज चोजन टू फोकस ऑन अ वेरी स्मॉल कंपोनेंट ऑफ द एंटायर लैंग्वेज डेवलपमेंट दैट शी नीड्स टू वर्क विद द चिल्ड्रन. तो उन्होंने सिर्फ सिक्वेंशियल वर्ड्स पे ज्यादा करके फोकस किया है, एंड हाउ टू कनेक्ट सेंटेंसेस, पहले आखिर बाद में फिर से, एज शी हैज ऑलरेडी दिस थिंग. नाउ This was the learning purpose. Now, a question to someone else would be, and I think someone is also trying to answer that, ki, what can you talk about the pedagogy? Ki yahan pe kya specific type of pedagogy yahan pe use hui hai? I think it's fairly straightforward, but agar aapko yaad hai, to humne ek 5 gole dekhe the pichle bari. To usme pehla gola tha ki humara lesson purpose kya hai, objective kya hai, is lesson ke end mein bachcho ko aana kya chahiye? इस पे हमने बात किया. सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वुड बी, आई मीन, डजंट नीड टू गो इन ऑर्डर, बट यू नो, व्हाट इज द पेडागॉजी दैट यू सी बीइंग यूज्ड ओवर हियर? और एनी कमेंट यू कुड मेक ऑन द, यू नो,
व्हेन यू, समबडी हैज सेड लर्नर सेंटर्ड हियर.
लर्नर सेंटर्ड
मेथड केटर्स टू द नीड्स ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स विद डिफरेंट लर्निंग स्टाइल्स एंड आल्सो स्टूडेंट्स विद डिफरेंट लर्निंग लेवल्स. सो यू नो, वी आर डिफरेंशिएटेड लर्निंग. Rachna Yadav also says experiential learning.
Correct.
Activity based learning.
Yeah, I mean, it's quite close, experiential learning, or even, so we often talk about experiential learning, but linking the experiential learning to the development of language is what the teacher is attempting to do over here. So surely usne activities wagera kiya hai, lekin wo activities ka jod wo learning outcome se lagana is something that the teacher has planned very carefully and done in this lesson. So yes, it is a type of experiential learning or playway method. I think these words sometimes, Ruchi, get used interchangeably, and I'm not quite sure what the technically the right term would be, but it is trying to give students a way to develop their language through experiencing language versus through, you know, simply learning it as grammar or learning. How do we normally teach conjunction? I don't know whether they're called conjunction or connecting words, right? If, then, but, and all these are conjunctions in English, right? Normally, when we teach grammar, we tend not to teach the language using any kind of experiential form of learning. Here, the teacher has tried to use that sort of a pedagogy. Do you want to add anything to this, Luchi? Or we could think of another dimension in all of this.
I think it's fine. I think you really explained very beautifully there. Although, I mean, these different words, playway and experiential learning, they seem to be very close, but they are also interpreted in a very mixed way. Like, people tend to think that if it is experiential, it is joyful also. And if it is joyful, it will definitely lead to some sort of learning. Although it may not be the case. It needs further deep thought and further exploration and reflection on our part.
To add to what you're saying or to ask is what did people think about the classroom environment? You know, could someone comment on, you know, what is the nature of, you know, I mean, just what is your first impression when you think about this classroom? What is the classroom environment like?
It was, first of all, what I observed, it was fearless. I mean, students were very confidently answer and they were responding without having the fear that their response would be wrong or right. So that is the first thing which I observed.
She noticed.
Yeah.
Aruna Prabhu has raised her hand, Ruchi.
I would like, since everybody had their own bit of square of paper, and if the teacher is speaking loud enough so that even the last bencher can hear properly, then everybody can participate in the activity, not just the person who is answering the teacher's question. So it was a more inclusive activity.
It was an inclusive environment where everybody got an opportunity to participate. Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Sudha, yes. Sudha, would you like to go next? Sudha, you had raised your hand.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, ma'am. What I thought is the class was very encompassing. It included all the 5 E's of education. It was very engaging at the first shot. And once the student gets engaged, the teacher very nicely motivated them to explore because they were asked to do on their own. And on the base of exploration, when they were working in pairs, one is working it out, then the other child is writing the method, the way to do. So that's a kind of explanation. That's the third step of learning. And then they elaborated over it, connecting sequential learning. And finally, they came to a conclusion that this is how the sentences were made. And origami was always, it's always an interesting art for child or even for us. Whenever we do also, we find it very interesting. So I thought this was a perfect class in a way.
Sudha, did you feel that there was any assessment being done? Because if the learning objective is that the children should be able to construct, say, 6 sentences and connect those sentences using sequential word, if this is the objective that the teacher had for this lesson, was the teacher able to assess whether the children have learned this, or was the learning objective achieved?
Definitely, because student was able to write and connect the sentences also. So at the end of the session, the child could write the whole thing and form proper sentences, which is a, I can say it's kind of, formative assessment on the spot.
Yeah. True. It is a type of formative assessment. Would anybody else like to have any, share anything else?
Yeah, I think Jasneet wanted to share her video. Jasneet, would you like to share the shorter one?
Yeah, I'm scared. Okay.
It's okay. I hope we are not scaring you out of it. We want to encourage more people. Instead, we should not be scaring.
I'd like to
share a little story before Jasmeet shares about the video that we just saw, jo Ishani ne select kiya hai. So this teacher was so super, super nervous because, you know, the session had started and this was a new class for her. And she didn't have a very deep relationship with the students. And she felt very underconfident in actually teaching Hindi because she herself is a Marathi speaker. So she didn't feel confident at all. So, throughout the almost for 10 months, we worked with her, right? And there were several times when she would just want to give up, you know, not just for the sake of the video, but she used to say that mere se nahi hoga ye, mere se nahi hoga, right? And when we told her that, can we think of one lesson idea that you will teach and all that, even then she said no, right? And finally, we were able to convince her, work with her, the video. The day this video was played, right, her principal and there were many other people, sort of education-linked people who came for the release of her video and all that, she just burst into tears. And she just cried and she cried and cried the day before. She says that, I cannot believe that you had so much confidence in me. I cannot believe that this has happened to me. I cannot believe. She just cried and cried. And it was such a simple thing. You know, but such was the fear in her and such was the thing ki ek to mujhe padhana nahi aata hai hindi fir upar se main kisi program mein ghus gayi hu fir mere wahan se expectation hai mera principal ka expectation hai fir aap upar se bol rahe ho video bhi banana hai fir mera ek class acha bhi dikhna chahiye. Oh my god, she was, I mean, throughout the program at least 3 times she just wrote a letter saying I just give up, I cannot do it. And whereas she's only teaching language, I mean, one would feel that it is not so complex also, and the children are young. No, it's primary school after all. But it was so hard and all that. And then just about 3-4 months back when she released, the day before that, she just, it was almost like a meltdown for her. It was such a revelation for her. And she kept thanking us, thank God you didn't let go of me. Thank God you had the faith in me. Thank God ki aapne mera hath nahi choda. And, you know, she just, in, you know, And now she's like, you know, yes, now I'm not afraid and all. But it took some 10 months for one teacher to make one lesson idea with just sequencing word and origami. Ye karne mein 10 mahine lag gaye. That was how hard it was. So I guess for
yes, everyone, and just that's why let me congratulate both Rachna Yadav and Ishani for taking the step and sharing their thoughts with us. And also now we eagerly wait for Jasneet. Jasneet, I hope you are feeling more comfortable now.
Yeah. I mean, okay, you first see, then I'll tell you the story behind it.
Okay, sure. Of course there are.
I mean, it's a trimmed one. It was a long video. So I've just tried to make it 1/4. And some extra part have also to come.
So I hope you can see the screen. I'll just show you how to do this. And I will share a link with
Can you please tell which concept you were trying to reach?
So basically, okay, I'll just give you the context of it. It's basically I'm teaching in a government school. I'm 9th to 12th graders, mathematics. And this is for grade 10. And we were dealing with the circle chapter. And one of the school synergy workshop only last year, I came to know about the live class feature of GeoGebra. So I tried to use that first time. And these students were not having, none of them in the government school is having laptop. They use their smartphones. And I mean, none of the teacher except me used to take live classes. I mean, online class on Zoom. They were used of WhatsApp classes. So this is the basic, I mean, context of this, my class. So basically we are dealing with circles where I want them to explore the properties of tangents of the circle through GeoGebra task. So I'll just start. It's a 6 minutes and I'll drag wherever I'll feel that no requirement is there.
Jasneet, just want to ask if you have shared the voice.
Oh, so sorry.
That's what I thought, because I was not able to hear anything. So when you stop, and when you share it, there are two things on the bottom. It says share voice and optimize for video clip.
Okay. I forgot.
It's okay.
Okay. So I hope you can see the screen. I'll just show you how to do this and then I will share a link to you jo aapne usko join karna hoga. I hope sabhi bachcho ko jo hai clear instructions mil rahi hai. Now I'll just show you ki isko isme kya hai aur kaise karna hai. Yahan par aapko ek circle dikh raha hai. As I have already told you that today we are going to do this chapter circle, जो कि हमारी बुक का 10th चैप्टर है तो इसका थोड़ा सा कॉन्सेप्ट समझने के लिए वी विल डू दिस एक्टिविटी फर्स्ट तो इस एक्टिविटी में आपने कुछ ऑब्जर्व करना है एंड यू हैव टू कम आउट वट एवर यू हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड इन दिस एक्टिविटी इस एक्टिविटी में कैसे आप कैसे इसको जो है आप प्ले करोगे दैट आई विल एक्सप्लेन आप सर्कल का और एक जो ये दूसरा ब्लू डॉट है इससे आप सर्कल को बड़ा या छोटा कर सकते हो आप इसको क्लिक करके इसको प्रेस करके ऊपर नीचे कर सकते हो देन यू कैन सी दिस इज द येलो सर्कल जो कि आउटसाइड द सर्कल है सॉरी येलो जो आपका पॉइंट है दैट इज आउटसाइड द सर्कल सो दिस इज द एक्सटर्नल पॉइंट नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू डू यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है स्लाइड मी तो आपने इसको स्लाइड करना है जब आप इसको स्लाइड करोगे तो आपको क्या दिखेगा क्या दिख रहा है आपको यहाँ पे के आई गिव यू 5 मिनट्स टाइम टू ऑब्जर्व आई जस्ट शो यू कि आप इसको स्लाइड करोगे तो आपको यहाँ पर कुछ कुछ नई नई चीजें नजर आती रहेंगी सो दिस इज द वे और आप इसको रीसेट भी कर सकते हो जैसे मैंने इसको रीसेट किया तो मैं अपना सर्कल बड़ा भी कर सकती हूँ एंड देन आई कैन अगेन ट्राई दिस सो नाउ आई एम जस्ट क्रिएटिंग अ क्लास. आपने क्या करना है, व्हाट्सएप पे मैं अभी भेज रही हूँ. व्हाट्सएप पर आपके पास एक अभी लिंक आएगा, आपको वो लिंक जो है वो क्लिक करके इसको किया राइट. और जहाँ पे स्लाइड में लिखा है आप उसको स्लाइड करोगे तो आपको एक्सटर्नल पॉइंट से जो बाहर दो है वहां से टेंजेंट्स आती हुई दिखेंगी. मतलब आपने क्या करना है, टास्क वन में इसको एक्सप्लोर करना है इंटरैक्टिव के साथ. जो आपको मैंने अभी भेजा है इंटरैक्टिव, उसके साथ प्ले करके थोड़ी देर खेल के यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व के इसमें क्या क्या हो रहा है, ठीक है. उसके बाद उसके नीचे कुछ क्वेश्चंस दे रखे हैं टास्क टू में, थ्री में, फोर में. जो इंटरैक्टिव आप जो जिसे प्ले कर रहे हो उसको देखते हुए, उसको ऑब्जर्व करते हुए आप जो है इन टास्क टू थ्री और फोर के आंसर दे दिए, ठीक है. तो आप शुरू कर दो अभी, देखो और फिर यू कैन ऑल्सो मूव टू टास्क टू टास्क थ्री. जैसे चंचल ने लिखा है, चंचल हैज कम टू टास्क टू ऑल्सो. व्हाट इज द मेजर ऑफ ईच पिंक एंगल डिस्प्लेड. तो आपका जैसे फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन जो है टास्क टू में लिखा हुआ है, मेरा मैं आपको म्यूट म्यूट कर लो. तो जैसे चंचल ने लिखा है यहाँ पर क्वेश्चन है आपका टास्क टू का कि पिंक वाला जो एंगल आपका बनता है जब आप स्लाइड करते हो, तो उस पिंक एंगल वो कितने डिग्री का है, उसका मेजरमेंट क्या है. 0 degree का है, 1 degree का है, 2 degree का है, 60 degree का है, 30 degree का है, 90 degree का है, 180 degree का है. सो दैट यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व एंड राइट. आपको ऑब्जर्व करना है, आपको देख के पता चल जाना चाहिए कि वो पिंक वाले जो एंगल्स हैं वो कितने डिग्री के लग रहे हैं आपको देखने से. सो दैट आंसर विल कम अंडर टास्क टू. तो अभी जिन जिन बच्चों ने ऑब्जर्व कर लिया वो टास्क टू पे लिख भी सकते हैं, वहां पे डायरेक्ट लिख दो. लिख दोगे तो वो मुझे यहाँ पे डायरेक्ट दिख जाएगा, दैट विल बी गुड, ठीक है. और टास्क थ्री जो है आपका, टास्क थ्री में भी चंचल आंसर करने की कोशिश कर रही है. व्हाट कैन यू कंक्लूड अबाउट द डिस्टेंसेस फ्रॉम द येलो पॉइंट दैट इज आउटसाइड द सर्कल ऑफ ईच ऑफ द स्मॉलर व्हाइट व्हाइट पॉइंट ऑन द सर्कल. तो इसमें ये पूछ रहे हैं कि जब आप इंटरैक्टिव में देख रहे हो कि दो रेज बढ़ती जा रही है बाह्य बिंदु से, येलो पॉइंट जो है वो बाह्य बिंदु है आपका, सर्कल के बाहर का बिंदु है एक्सटर्नल पॉइंट. वहां से दो रेज आ रही हैं जो सर्कल को किसी एक पॉइंट पर मीट करती हुई आगे चली जाती हैं, टच करती हुई आगे चली जाती हैं. तो अब आपने ये देखना है कि जो डिस्टेंस है येलो पॉइंट का किस पॉइंट से, जहां पर रे ने सर्कल को जो है टच करती हुई गई है, वहां से लेकर, मतलब व्हाइट पॉइंट है उसको व्हाइट से वहां पे डिनोट कर रखा है, व्हाइट से येलो पॉइंट तक का डिस्टेंस जो है वो, उसके बारे में आप क्या कह सकते हो, क्या आप कंक्लूड कर पा रहे हो. तो राइट व्हाटएवर इज कमिंग इन योर माइंड. सो चंचल इज आल्सो ट्राइंग टू डू. अभी बीच में स्लाइडिंग वगैरह करोगे तो आपको थोड़ा और अच्छे से.
So I think it was really interesting. You were able to see all the students' work, no? There, right, Jasneet?
Yeah. It was really interesting. But now I have changed my strategy a lot.
Okay. So tell us about it. Tell us what is your reflection on that video and why you have changed your strategy. Eager to hear.
Okay. But thanks a lot, because yesterday only I got the chance to actually reflect on my own videos, and it was really a great experience. And then only I shared two videos to Ruchi ma'am, just to say that I could find there is a huge change between the first this video and the another one. I was very confident after attending that synergy workshop that when I am observing my students' work, there will be certainly be something and students will try to do. and maybe students were doing it and I was observing that they are playing with that, and they might be internalizing some of the properties of tangents, but unfortunately none of the student could communicate even a single property to me in this class. So this was like I thought something will happen and students will start speaking and they will burst on me, but nothing has happened after half an hour in this. And why I thought that this link would end maybe just in a half an hour or till the time I'm on a Zoom class, but after some time I realized that if I send this work only through WhatsApp, it may be stay there for 1 or 2 days and students can work on it at their own pace till the time and whenever they get time. So now the change in my strategy is that I share the link, create class link through WhatsApp, and I give them time, 1 or 2 days. And then after sharing this great, when they take 1 or 2 days, then on through Zoom class, I try to discuss with them whatever they have observed in whatever has come to their mind, and whatever is the properties or what concepts they have internalized. And one of my important, I would say, learning from these videos, the second one, I can just verbalize it. I mean, it was about linear equations, and where students were asked to find out the trick I am using in the linear equations. I was changing the coefficient and I wanted them to observe that in which kind of coefficients, what is the relationship between the coefficients of pair of linear equations when they are getting parallel lines, or whenever they are getting coincident lines, or whenever they are getting intersecting lines. So it took 35 minutes, and after that they come up, like one of the students said that maybe I am writing the multiples of the in the coefficients to get the parallel lines. So I mean, if we are giving some task, I think patience plays very important role, and one has to be, what should I say, that I cannot give up, that if my students are not saying, they will not internalize the concept. It's not like that. They will take their own time. And maybe because these are the mature students and they have not learned in the way I am dealing with now. They have always done the way, Blackboard teaching, and everything is taught to them, everything is told them, but here they had to explore it. So it take double or triple time what I expect from them. So this is my one of the important learning, I would say. And I want you to also, give some comments. I know there are many loopholes I could also observe now, because it was a spontaneous class, and now I can reflect on it better as an observer.
Isn't that always the case? I mean, even if I see this video again of what we are recording right now, I will find that there would be like so many ways in which I would have steered the discussion, so many points that I might have missed from some people coming and taking it up for discussion itself. So I understand that is always the case, but it helps. It certainly helps to see that video again to reflect on it, because slowly and slowly these thoughts somewhere in the back of mind remind us while we are teaching, and it helps us to incorporate those points in our practice. And I think that's why this is this reflection is so important. What do you think, Uma?
I think your children are very lucky that they have a teacher who is sort of so determined and so patient, right? And especially in a time like this when you're trying to teach online, you're going to probably need so much more patience. So I would first congratulate you to actually take the first step. एक तो मुझे पता है मुझे patience रखना है, एक तो मुझे जाके दोबारा देखना है कि मैं और कैसे improve कर सकती हूँ. So that you have been able to sort of go over these first two steps is in of itself a very big thing. And I think if I was a child in your class, I would be very happy to think कि मेरी teacher इतना मेरे लिए सोच रही है कि मुझे अभी नहीं आया तो मैं चलो इस तरह से पढ़ा के देखती हूँ. Let me try this way, let me try that way. So I think that's really something worth sort of appreciating.
Yeah, and in this pandemic time and online learning, we can see like it becomes even more difficult, because at least in face-to-face learning, we had this square paper, we had this other student just sitting beside that other student, you're doing things together, you're writing it together, the teacher is writing on the blackboard. All these things just become so easy, and the same thing to replicate it, we are trying to replicate it on our online mode, it becomes so difficult.
It might have been a little spontaneous, and I understand that. So, aapne dekhi, jab shuru kiya lesson, to aapne bola ki, you know, like I have already told you, we are going to learn about the circle, right? And then you proceeded with the lesson. So, in your mind, what was it that you wanted the children to learn at the end of the lesson? Aapne lots of instructions bachcho ko diya ki aapko kya dikh raha hai, then you took them to the classroom, you know, and then you guided them. So aise bahut sare steps hue. So right at the very beginning, when you began this lesson, what is it that you really wanted them to learn at the end of this lesson?
Yeah, actually this specific applet is basically to explore that the distance of from the external point to of the tangents is, I mean, tangents are always equal if you draw it from the external points. So that is the one thing that I wanted them to observe. And the second thing, that another property that I mean, they could make out through the applet only, that whenever the radius and the tangent, wherever they meet at the point of contact, it always makes a 90 degree angle. Its radius is perpendicular to the tangent. This is the second property that I wanted them to observe. And the third one is that through this applet only, there was another property that they could observe, that the distance from the center to the external point is always greater than the distance, the length of the tangent. So these were the three properties I had in mind that I want them to observe through this task. And because we were also connecting through WhatsApp, so my usual habit is that I give them first to read the introduction of the chapter of the book. So that's why I had already told them that we will be doing chapter 10, that is circles, and they know that they are supposed to read the introduction. So that was done through WhatsApp only. So they read it, and then I gave them this task so that maybe they get some context of it. So that was my
objective. Very nice. So just listen, aap bol, there were almost three things that you wanted them to arrive at, right?
Yeah.
So, what would be helpful is for you to think of the pedagogic steps to arrive at that. Because when you are saying that children will observe karenge, and then they will arrive at a conclusion, right? Mm-hmm. And if you noticed, if you watch your video, there were a number of words that were being used, which is mathematical vocabulary, right? So, kaun sa mathematical vocabulary unko pehle already aana chahiye? Okay, phir what would be the next step, right? Mm-hmm. Right. So, when you began, if you notice the language that you have used, शुरू में आपने एक सर्कल किया, फिर आपने एक येलो डॉट को आगे पीछे किया, फिर एक ये किया. सो व्हाट यू आर एक्चुअली डूइंग वाज गेटिंग देम फैमिलियर विद दैट टूल इटसेल्फ, राइट? सो मे बी यू कुड कंसीडर व्हाट इज अनदर वे टू गेट देम फैमिलियर विद द टूल, राइट? एस्पेशली मे बी चैलेंजिंग राइट नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ ऑनलाइन, बट व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप टुवर्ड्स अराइविंग एट दैट कंक्लूजन दैट यू नो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द टेंजेंट, दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रॉपर्टी दैट यू वॉन्ट देम टू अराइव एट. ओके, वो प्रॉपर्टी के लिए अराइव करने के लिए उसकी प्री स्टेप्स बच्चों को क्या आने चाहिए? मतलब दे नीड टू नो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ सर्कल, दे नीड टू नो व्हाट इज अ सेंटर पॉइंट, दे नीड टू नो यू नो सम फोर फाइव थिंग्स, राइट? सो यू नीड टू हैव दैट. आई मीन रुचि, लाइक इफ दिस वाज अ रेगुलर क्लास ना, प्रोबेबली यू वुड पुट आउट द वोकैबुलरी वर्ड्स बिफोर. जब ये चार चीजें उनको पहले आनी चाहिए, फिर उसके बाद ये, फिर उसके बाद ये, फिर उसके बाद ये, तो आपके लेसन में ना बहुत सारी चीजें साथ साथ हो रही थी, राइट? You were asking them to, you know, aur kaun si property aapko dikh rahi hai, ab aap ye bhi dekho, ab aap ye bhi dekho. There were lots of things that were happening. So cognitively for a child, and especially in an online mode, it may be hard to grasp everything at one shot. Because aapke dimaag mein to wo sara clear hai. Lekin bachche ko pehle kahan pe break, in that lesson, which is the first break you take? And how do you assess whether the child has understood the first property? So it's a very great idea that you have ki wo explore karenge, khud se explore karenge and arrive karenge. But in order for children to arrive at a property, it's very difficult, okay? So how would you get them to arrive at a property? Would So let us say that you give them an activity and say ki aap aisi line char jagah draw karke dekho, is length ki char line is tarah se draw karke dekho, then record your observation. Now tell me what have you arrived at. From this can we conclude that this is the property, because if you leave it open ended ki aap explore karo aur aake mujhe batao wo property, shayad wo bacche, you know, it's a little hard for the children to do it, but you need to give them a set of observations to make, bring that pattern of observations to arrive at that conclusion. Right, Ruchi?
Yeah, I think these are really helpful points. It even made me think a little bit. Like, what if we allow, I understood that you made that applet and it can be very useful. But what if we also ask the children to explore that on pen and paper also? Just making drawings, not essentially constructions, but just making drawing and thinking, and even constructions also. What happens if you increase the size of the circle? What happens when you decrease the size of the circle? What happens when you take the point away, far away from the circle? What happens when you bring the point closer to the circle? So yes, the applet has flexibility in certain variables that you had thought, but maybe there could be other aspects also that students could also have thought about. Which might have helped them in making those observations, and perhaps also pointing out things to observe. I do not, it might, you might feel that, okay, this is like giving away some things, but it might help students in focusing, because when one is starting in especially geometry, the biggest problem I feel that what students have is like where to focus, what property to focus. There are so many things out there. So one which you used to do is to given like describe the shape, describe the figure that you are seeing in front of you. And if you would have asked them to just focus on the length of the tangents, the angles, you had pointed that out and you perhaps wanted them to come up on their own. But if they're not able to, maybe we can give, okay, just look at the length, just look at the angle, maybe that kind of thing. And maybe you would have tried that also.
The smaller units.
Yeah.
You're saying, right?
Yeah. Maybe you did it already in the next session. I don't know.
Yeah, that was really a nice observations and good inputs that I could take. But yes, I'm not going to defend, but normally in my offline mode or before this applet, I actually explain, I try to first focus on the mathematical vocabulary, where I usually give them the task to read the introduction and find out the words which they find difficult, they don't understand. It might be a mathematical or it might be a Hindi word. So they come up, we have a range of words, then we try to discuss those words. And another task which Ruchi pointed out, I also try that task before this applet, that I ask them to draw a circle in their notebook and take any line, think about a line, and just think if you pass what if you just take that line and circle on a on the paper, then what are the possibilities of whether it will cut or it will touch or it will remain outside. I mean, I didn't speak out like that only, but I wanted them to just observe. Just by drawing a rough circle and a line, and just to observe, yeah. Then they were coming out with some of the thing, like it will touch, it will, they call it, jaise book mein de rakha, it's a chhedak rekha karke wo bolte hain. So when they draw it, then they suddenly said it's a chhedak rekha, abhi jo hume mil raha hai, it's touching the circle. So jo shabd unhe mushkil bhi lag rahe the, they just try to come up the meaning of it by drawing it. So that was the first task I did before doing this applet. But yes, I agree that I am finding that I spoke a lot in this particular applet, and I could have broken it to get more sense, and maybe this is the reason why my student could not speak out. So this thing, I mean,
हो सकता है, एक तो आप ऑनलाइन मोड में है ना, तो उसमें तो और मुश्किल एनीवे देयर इज, बट कॉग्निटिवली मे बी यू नीड टू ब्रेक इट अप इनटू स्मॉलर 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 टास्क फॉर द चिल्ड्रन टू अंडरस्टैंड. फॉर एग्जांपल द इंस्ट्रक्शन यू गिव इज दैट नाउ प्ले अराउंड विद इट, राइट? प्ले अराउंड मींस व्हाट, व्हाट डू आई हैव टू डू? सो परहैप्स आवर इंस्ट्रक्शन कैन बी, व्हेन आई से प्ले अराउंड आई मीन यू विल ड्रॉ फोर फाइव लाइंस, यू विल पुल you know, you will make 4 or 5 angles. So what do you mean by play around? So it may be clear in your head, but what exactly is the child supposed to understand when, as a teacher, my teacher is telling me to play around. So mujhe kya karna hai ne?
Right? I mean, somehow I also feel, I mean, I don't know whether I'm right or not, because somehow I feel that if I just make them very bounded, so then it may be that I am stopping them to come out with some extraordinary property, which even I could not see. So that is one of the things that I could not say specifically, that you have to only look at the length, or you have to only look at the distance between external and internal points. So, I mean, there may be the property that they could observe and I would have never seen in that. And there are chances I have got such kind of answers, which I never observed. So that's why I try to restrict myself to be very specific and breaking into...
Slightly more open-ended, you feel
yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
Okay, Shalini, can you share the link of the feedback form? I think there is one person who wanted to.
Yeah, ma'am.
So Uma, I think without any further ado, if you can share those points that you were saying. Sorry, we got extended quite a lot.
I recollect, are you talking about inquiry-based learning? I think that maybe you could do it at a separate session.
Yeah, maybe a separate session would be better, because right now we have extended 20 minutes more than the session. Maybe some other session we can take it. Yeah.
There's a video called Word Flow, which is one of my favorites for language learning. Maybe anytime you go to teacher pages, you see.
Yeah. Or if you can just post on chat, Uma, some of the resources people can look for inquiry-based learning or language learning that you feel are useful within teacher space, pages or outside. I think that would be useful, because then they will have something to go for after they have done this. Okay, so the pressure video in physics, Uma says, is a good one if you want to explore more about inquiry.
Because there also the teacher is trying to get them to the definition of pressure. So
yeah.
It's a bit like how Jasneet was trying to get them to understand the property. No? The teacher is also trying to get them to understand the property or whatever, the definition of what is pressure. She does it through a series of activities.
Yeah. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you everyone for being here and for contributing to this session in some way or another. It was really nice to see the videos that you had liked or shared, and also the kind of reflections that you have shared, the kind of questions that you have shared here. We look forward to having more teacher sessions, engaging teacher sessions with all of you. So please continue to come to these sessions also, and start sharing your own ideas in that. Yeah, that's all. Thanks a lot, Uma, for providing so many useful, helpful comments and questions to the people who were sharing their ideas. I'm sure it will help all of us in reflecting further on the practice of teaching itself.
Thank you. We also keep learning. I'm just posting the link that someone has asked me to, and then I will close it.
Sure. So when you fill up this feedback form and submit it, you will get immediately, you will receive your e-certificate in your mail. Just wanted to tell that to the people. Thank you, Ishani. Thanks for sharing your idea. Thank you, Tarun. You made very nice comments. Sorry, was someone speaking?
No. So the two videos that I've sent, you could look at that.
Yeah.
All right. It was wonderful meeting everyone, and good luck.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Uma.
Bye.
Others also, if you have filled up your feedback form and got your certificate, you can log off. I'm going to stop my recording right now.